after years enmeshed in filth, Chinese football is limbering up for a fresh start. The bad things are in the past, this player says. It's going to get better. Former professional players like Shang Yi say that at its height, the corruption was blatant. One game became quite famous, he says. My team went on strike and refused to play because the referee was so biased. Now the arrival in China of star names like Didier Drogba and Nicolas Anelka is perhaps a sign that things might really be changing. But the fact that they both lasted barely half a season, with rumours over financial disputes at their Shanghai club, suggests problems persist.
At the start of a new season, as the justifiably cynical fans trudge through the turnstiles and up the stadium steps, the truth is there is not a club in Chinese football that has not been touched by the rot. Attendances are slowly improving again, but with Europe now facing its own match-fixing scandal, China's experience should serve as a warning to the world.
If you let corruption grow unchecked, these fans tell me, you risk losing supporters forever.
They don't want to watch it again, because it is not a real match.
We think we've been cheated, and everything is faked, and we don't believe it.
But the real test will be longer term and measured in empty seats. John Sudworth, BBC News, Guangzhou.